Judy has a spotlight segment that really talks about the symptoms and really the challenges that could bring on a stroke, like high blood pressure, diabetes. So she just wants this opportunity to, bring awareness. That's what our show is about. Our show is about bringing awareness, telling stories, really making a difference in the life, and really for you to see that it's not your grandparents that suffer a stroke. I'm going to be right back.
Okay. Strokes usually happen to people without any notice, and it can be scary and a life-threatening event. If stroke doesn't cause death, it will cause many other issues. It may take a long time to recover, if recovery is possible, and these issues are loss of muscle movement, complete paralysis, trouble swallowing or talking, memory loss, difficult thinking clearly, trouble with reasoning and understanding, emotional issues, pain, numbness, sensitive to temperature changes, change in behavior, and inability to care for yourself. Here are the 8 reasons strokes happen: high blood pressure, tobacco, heart disease and diabetes, heavy drinking, lack of exercise, medication, and age. Anyone at any time could have a stroke. As I said, it could be an unborn baby right through to the senior citizen. Anyone at any time. And high cholesterol. Stroke symptoms are fatigue, unusual vision problems, usually in one eye, one arm becoming weak or numb, slurred speech, dizziness, trouble thinking, severe headache or migraine, trouble walking, inability to put both arms in the air without one of them dropping down or drooping down, and half of your face drooping. 8 warning signs of a stroke that you should not ignore: loss of consciousness, fainting, being short of breath, being disoriented, having the hiccups, being agitated, more agitated than usual, being in pain, and abrupt changes in behavior. How do you prevent a stroke? Control your high blood pressure. Lower the amount of cholesterol in your diet. Avoid tobacco, and even avoid secondhand smoke. Manage your diabetes. Lose weight or maintain a healthy weight. Eat healthy foods. Exercise on a regular basis. Consume alcohol in moderation or not at all. Avoid recreational drugs. Take medication to treat heart disease. And this one I love: eat dark chocolate daily.
I like that one too.
Some final thoughts. Strokes are normally completely unexpected. The longer it takes to get medical treatment, the more damaging the stroke. An example of this is one of our guests who shared his story was Bob Mandel. Bob Mandel was coming home from work. His wife was a teacher, and she was going to a meeting after class, and he wasn't feeling well, and he decided to go to the doctor, who examined him and thought he possibly had a cold or something. Nothing to worry about. He came home. He lived in Connecticut in a duplex. He went upstairs. He started to feel worse. He looked in the mirror and he saw his face was drooping, and he realized that his speech was beginning to, he was slurring his speech. He went to the phone and called 911 and said, "My name's Bob Mandel. I live in this duplex, the address. I'm having a stroke, but don't come." Okay? Now that was very foolish of him to say, but he wasn't really thinking clearly, and 911 operators didn't come. Then he realized he's upstairs and he has to get downstairs. So, and he can't walk anymore. He rolled himself down a flight of stairs, very dangerous. And then he passed out. A few hours later, he heard his wife coming in, and she looked at him and she said, "Oh my God." She calls 911 and 911 says, "Oh, Mrs. Mandel, you're home." That's ridiculous. They should have come right away. You need help immediately. Because of this, because of the delay, it took him about 18 years to recover. He is now president and founder of, I think it's Stroke Foundation, Stroke Recovery Foundation, and he's living down in Florida now. So call 911 immediately. Give them the facts and make sure they come and tell them that this person, if it's you, I'm having a stroke. Or if it's somebody in your family, they're having a stroke, so that the ambulance people know about it. The stroke numbers are 6,000 people in New York will annually die from strokes. 795,000 people nationwide who are affected by strokes each year. 129,000 people across the country will die annually from strokes, and $34 billion is the number nationwide medical and rehab costs for stroke. And I want to finish with a news article that was in Newsday on December 9th. And they were talking about Stony Brook Hospital investing $2.2 million for two mobile emergency ambulances stationed at the Long Island Expressway exits in Suffolk County, with goals of reducing disability and improving stroke survival rates. Those mobile units are equipped with CT scanner that will determine if a patient has a blocked vessel or bleeding from the brain. The rolling emergency rooms will hit the road in March and carry a crew of stroke first responders in vehicles containing state-of-the-art brain imaging equipment and pharmaceuticals. Each unit will have a critical technologist on board. These mobile units will be stationed in Suffolk County at the Long Island Expressway exits 57 in Islandia and another one at exit 68 in Shirley. And I think this is a wonderful idea. It's happening in March. I think that other hospitals should think about it, and we should have more of this across the country. Thank you.
believe there comes a time when everything just falls in line. We live and learn from our mistakes. The deepest cuts are here our face. Now I believe there comes a time when everything just falls in line. We live and learn from our mistakes. The deepest cuts are here our face. Now I believe there comes a time when everything just falls in line.